Sometimes an ironing board just isn't big enough. For those cases, I made an ironing mat that basically turns my table into a big ironing board. Let me show you how I made it. The key component is this heat-reflecting batting, and it's also used for pot holders and stuff like that. I'm using some old cotton towels to provide extra insulation. And then some nice cotton fabric for the top and bottom. You only want to be using cotton on this project, since other fabrics may have trouble handling the heat. To make sure this combination of layers would do the trick, I put them in order and did a quick ironing test. Even on the highest setting, the bottom only gets slightly warm, so I'm good to go. I started by cutting the bands off the towel so that they're able to lie flat. I sewed the towels together to get as big of a piece as I could, and then I cut the towels into two identical rectangles. They ended up being 64 by 140 centimeters. I cut the other layers to this size as well. Now I took my time putting all the layers together, and I made sure there were no wrinkles. I started with the bottom layer of cotton fabric, then I added the towel, the heat-reflecting batting with the silver side up, another towel, and then the final layer of cotton fabric. I added some pins around the edge to make sure nothing would shift, and then I sewed all the way around to attach the layers together. I also added a few lines of stitching across the surface to keep everything in place permanently. Some of the layers had stretched more than others, so I cut closely around the stitching to make all the edges line up. To finish the edge, I'm using bias tape. To apply it, fold one side open, line it up with the edge, and stitch it down on top of the fold. When you get to a corner, stop sewing about half a centimeter from the edge. Cut your threads and fold the bias tape to the side, making a 45-degree angle at the corner. Then fold the bias tape back over itself, lining it up with the next side. Start sewing again at the edge, and this creates a nice mitered corner. When you come all the way around, fold the beginning of the bias tape over and keep sewing until you passed it. Then you can fold the bias tape to the front. At the corners, continue folding one edge straight inwards until the end. When you now continue with the next edge, you'll get a nice mitered corner again. I'm sewing the remainder of my bias tape into a strap by folding in the ends and stitching it closed. I then folded it in half and slid it underneath the bias tape in the middle of one of the shorter sides. Sew the binding tape in place by stitching close to the inner edge all the way around. I added some extra stitching around the straps to make the connection a bit stronger. And finally, I added my label. There you go! A portable ironing mat that turns any table into an ironing board. I know this is going to come in very handy for me very soon, so stay tuned for that. I'll see you next time. Bye!